Hi, in this video, we will walk through the major steps of digestion by each class of macronutrient. This will help you to understand the difference between mechanical and chemical digestion and how the digestion and absorption processes differ for each class. Digestion is essentially the process of breaking down food into smaller molecules that can be absorbed. Absorption is the act then of bringing those molecules into cells. Mechanical digestion is, as it sounds, the physical breakdown of food into smaller pieces. Mechanical digestion begins in your mouth with chewing. It continues in your stomach with the churning of your stomach muscles. And then there is segmentation and peristalsis throughout your entire GI tract to move food along. Your GI tract is actually made up of primarily muscle for this reason. So chemical digestion, on the other hand, involves enzymes breaking apart bonds. Chemical digestion is the bulk of digestion, and it's the final step. It also varies by nutrient, so chemical digestion is then what we're going to focus on for the rest of this video. And we're going to start now with carbohydrates. So carbohydrates for this conversation can be broken down into four categories. That's monosaccharides, disaccharides, starches, and fiber. And pardon my lovely drawing here, this is representing the GI tract, and we're going to go through what happens in the mouth, the stomach, the small intestine, and the large intestine for each of these. So monosaccharides are essentially single sugar units. Because they're already single units, there's really no chemical digestion that needs to take place. So they're going to pass all the way through to the small intestine with, say, no chemical digestion going on. And then in the small intestine, we'll have these single units, and they'll be absorbed right into small intestinal cells. So nothing then is going to be left in the large intestine, because pretty much everything will be absorbed then in the small. The disaccharides are made up of two single units bonded together, so they will need an enzyme to break apart that bond, and that is going to happen in the small intestine. So it's going to be an intestinal enzyme. And then it'll break it apart into that single unit. You'll have two of those, and those will both be absorbed into the small intestine cells and go into the blood. Starches are many units bonded together. So we actually have an enzyme in the saliva. So it'll be salivary. It's called amylase. And that will start to act on that chain and break it apart into smaller chains. And once it hits the stomach, it's going to actually be deactivated by hydrochloric acid because that pH is so low. When we get back into the small intestine, you're going to have the intestinal and pancreatic enzymes. That are going to finish the breakdown of the chain of starches. And it's still going to end up as a single monosaccharide and get absorbed into the small intestine. So you can see then both with disaccharides and starches, there's going to be nothing left once it hits that large intestine. Fiber, on the other hand, we don't have as humans the bond to break apart. So there is going to be no chemical digestion at all. It'll pass straight through to the large intestine, and the bacteria in our gut can actually act upon some fiber, so we'll say may metabolize. Other fiber is going to pass straight on through and be excreted. Okay, so you can see that with the monosaccharides, disaccharides, and starches, that single sugar unit is the final step of digestion. And then when it's absorbed, these are all going to go through what's called the portal vein, which goes directly into the liver. So that will be the next step after absorption. Okay, next we're going to talk about protein. So you might think of meat like beef, but it can also be in vegetables. And protein is essentially a long chain of amino acids that's then folded. And so that's what this globular shape up here is representing. So when we look at proteins, there is no chemical digestion going on in the mouth. You obviously do have that mechanical digestion with chewing starting to unfold the protein, but in the stomach is where it's really going to start to break down. So the hydrochloric acid can act upon the protein and start to, it's called denaturing, where it will unfold. And then you have enzymes called proteases that will start to break apart the chain into shorter linkages. So I'll just draw a short amino acid chain here in the stomach. So it'll start to be more of a linear chain of amino acids. And then in the small intestines, we're going to have pancreatic and intestinal enzymes, just like with our carbohydrates. So we'll have pancreatic enzymes that are going to break it down almost all the way, and our intestinal enzymes are going to make that final step where we have single amino acids that are going to be absorbed then into the blood. And again, nothing left in the large intestines. So you'll see then our amino acids are our final step of protein digestion. And just like carbohydrates, this is going to feed directly into the portal vein and go to the liver. Okay, our last class here is lipids. Lipids are essentially oils or fats, and they're made up of triglycerides. So you'll see at the top TG, I'm going to write that out for short. And in for lipids, we have salivary lipase in the mouth. So that will start our chemical digestion, but it's very limited. So I'll put limited salivary lipase because there's really not a lot of time to start that chemical digestion, but there is some. And then there's not going to be any in the stomach because just like with that salivary amylase, it's going to be deactivated. But once we hit the small intestines, here's where it gets a little bit different from the other molecules because we have something called bile. So bile is made in your liver and then it's stored in the gallbladder and then will be released directly into your small intestine. And what it does is emulsifies the fat, so it surrounds it, and it forms these things called micelles. And so this essentially is giving a surface area for the enzymes to act upon by breaking apart that fat into smaller units. So it's surrounding the triglycerides. And then we'll have the pancreatic and intestinal enzymes that will then act upon that micelle and break it down to free fatty acids. So I'm just going to write FA for fatty acid. And those fatty acids are what are going to get absorbed into the small intestinal cells. So we can see fatty acid is our final step. But I do want to note here then that there are a few different things that happen in the small intestinal cells. You can see this on the side. So the fatty acids are actually going to be repackaged then into triglycerides. So they were really just broken down to get across that border. And then in the small intestine, they'll be packaged into chylomicrons. So that's essentially going to be another little unit circling that triglyceride and sent into the lymph. And then it'll be drained into your blood and go into circulation. And the real highlight here is that the lymph is going to bypass the liver. Instead of like the other nutrients that are going straight into the liver. And the difference with lipids, you can see they are not water soluble, while our proteins and carbohydrates are water soluble. And the same thing though, there is not going to be much left in the large intestine. Okay, so I know this was a highly simplified flow through digestion, but hopefully it helps you to see the big picture and the differences between each nutrient And then also I want to point out that one thing to keep in mind is that these things are all happening at the same time. So it's not like your body's like, oh, let me take this lipid all the way through. No, you usually eat a meal that has all of these classes, and this is going on simultaneously. All right, that is all for now. I hope you have a wonderful day.